Hello. Today, I'm going to explain about resistors. Resistors are one of the most basic electronic components. These are resistors. Resistors are crucial components used in almost all electronic circuits. For example, let's have a look at this device. On the circuit board, there are resistors. Many resistors are arranged here. I'll explain what resistors can do by showing some experiments. Here, I have a power supply and an LED. LED is supposed to light up when I connect it to the power supply. Let's do it. What? It lit up only for a second and went out? Should I turn up the voltage? Let's try. I made a terrible mistake. I connected the LED and power supply in series. However, the current that flows through an LED increases rapidly when the voltage reaches a certain level. That's the current voltage characteristics of LED. This means that if you connect the power supplies in series with an LED, too much current will flow and the LED will heat up and eventually burn. Then what can we do to light up an LED without damaging it with too much current? Connect a resistor in series. So the first role of a resistor is to control the current. There's the same LED as the one used earlier in a resistor. Let's connect them in series. Connected them in series and now voltage is being applied. The LED lit up. LEDs usually start lighting up from 2 to 3 volts. Earlier I applied too much voltage to the LED and it burned, but this time it doesn't burn. It's not broken. I'm increasing the voltage, but the LED doesn't burn easily. When a resistor and a power supply are connected in series, V is equal to IR, according to Ohm's law. V is the power supply voltage, I is the current flowing through the resistor, and R is the resistance value of the resistor. This resistance is called electrical resistance. Electrical resistance is a measure of opposition to the flow of electric current. Higher resistance allows less current to flow, lower resistance allows more current to flow. The unit of electrical resistance is ohm. Let's transform the formula to calculate the current that flows through the resistor. I is equal to V, divided by Earl. That means in this simple circuit, you can control the current by controlling the resistance value. If you increase the resistance value, less current flows. If you decrease the resistance value, more current flows. Same goes when an LED is connected. If you connect a resistor to an LED in series, you can calculate the current that flows through this circuit by using this formula. Power voltage minus LED voltage equals to the voltage across the resistor. If you divide it by the resistance value, you can find the amount of current. When an LED is lit, the applied voltage is approximately 223 volts, so you can easily calculate the current. I have two different resistors here. I'm applying voltage. Can you see? The LED is lighting up. This one's emitting weak light. The other one is very bright. They differ in brightness. The weak one is connected to a resistor with a large resistance value. Therefore, less current is flowing. The bright one is connected to a resistor with a small resistance value. Therefore, more current flows, which makes the LED brighter. As you can see, there are resistors with various resistance values. How do they control the resistance value of a resistor? Let's take a look at carbon film resistors as an example. Carbon film resistors are made of carbon. Carbon conducts electricity. There's a mechanical pencil lead here. Let's connect a resistance meter. A pencil lead has a resistance value, and it's 10 ohm. 10 ohm is quite low. A pencil lead has a low resistance value. How do they control the resistance values of carbon film resistors? I'll use a pencil, which is made of carbon, to draw something like this. Let's measure the resistance value of the area filled in with a pencil. The resistance value is approximately 7 kilo ohm. Carbon conducts electricity well, so how do they control the resistance value of carbon? I'll erase the filled in area with an eraser. Take a close look at the resistance value. The resistance value has increased. Earlier it was 7 kilo ohm, but now it increased to 12 kilo ohm. Carbon conducts electricity, but if you erase it with an eraser, the current can't run on the area. As a result, less current flows, which increases the resistance value. Let's make another groove. The resistance value has increased to 27 kilo ohm. It seems even harder for current to flow. Let's make another groove and see the value. This is how to control the resistance value of a resistor. First, prepare a carbon film through which current runs easily. Then, if you want to increase the resistance value, make many grooves to increase the resistance. As the number of grooves increases, in other words, the longer the current path gets, the greater the resistance value becomes. Now, how do they control the resistance values of the actual products? The key is in the manufacturing process. On top of an insulator, which does not conduct electricity, a really thin layer of carbon is generated. After that, they cut a groove in the carbon film, as in a figure, in a spiral shape. By cutting the film in spiral, you can make the current path longer. Then the resistance value increases. You can control the resistance value only by making slight changes. Now, how do you identify the resistance value of a resistor? You can do it by reading color code. This is the color code. There are color bands on the surface of the resistor. Color bands are printed on the surface of the resistor. You can tell the resistance value by the colors. Some resistors have 4 colored bands or 5 colored bands. Instead of color codes, some resistors have resistance values printed on them. This one's 10 ohm. Depending on the resistance value, color bands can be more colorful. If the resistor has 4 bands, the first to third lines from the left show the resistance value, and the band on the far right shows the resistance tolerance. In this video, I won't go into detail on color codes. If you want to know more, please check the link in the description. There are detailed explanations. Now, let's actually measure the resistance values. This carbon film resistor has brown, black, brown, and gold bands. So, the resistance value is 100 ohm. The gold band shows the resistance tolerance, which is plus or minus 5%. Let's measure the actual resistance value. It's 98.3 ohm. It's not 100 ohm. Let's check other resistors in the bunch as well. This one is 98.1 ohm, a little smaller. The nominal resistance value is 100 ohm, but the actual values are a little bit different. The resistance value's allowed deviation from the nominal value is called resistance tolerance. The tolerance is indicated by the color code. This resistor's nominal resistance is 100 ohm, and the color of the band that indicates the tolerance is gold, which means the tolerance is plus or minus 5%. The resistance of these resistors is always within plus or minus 5% from 100 ohm. If you actually measure the resistance values of tens and hundreds of thousands of resistors, the values would exhibit a normal distribution. The average of the measured values would be 100 ohm. Each one of them may not be exactly 100 ohm, but the average is 100 ohm. Resistance tolerance indicates how precise the resistance values are. The ones we use today were cheap carbon film resistors, so they're not so precise. But there are more precise resistors. It's metal film resistor. Metal film resistors are more precise. Some metal film resistors have only plus or minus 1% tolerance, which means the resistance values are always within the range of plus or minus 1%. I'm checking the resistance value of a precision resistor with 1 kilo ohm plus or minus 1% resistance. It is within plus or minus 1%. Let's have a look at other resistors in the bunch. This one's 998 ohm. Very good. The one we saw just now has a tolerance of plus or minus 1%. But there are even more precise ones like plus or minus 0.1%, but they are quite expensive. This one's tolerance is plus or minus 0.1%, 0.1% of 1 kilo ohm. So the resistance should be within plus or minus 1 ohm. It's 999.97 ohm. It's within range. Amazing. I checked other resistors as well, but of course they were all within plus or minus 0.1%. I've explained so far about the first role of resistors, which is to limit the excess flow of current. I believe you understand the role by now. Actually, resistors have other roles. The second role is to act as loads. In other words, you can use resistors to consume electric power. Earlier, I showed a mechanical pencil lead as an example. You can actually use it as a resistive load. Let's give it a try. As mechanical pencil leads generate a lot of heat, you need to be careful when experimenting. It doesn't get hot. The power was not on. Initially, the oil contained in the lead evaporates, as you can see, and after that, it gets really, really hot like this. It turned red. So much heat. This is really intense. A lead of a mechanical pencil is made of carbon, so it burns. The upper one is the one used in the experiment. It became thin and looks like a cinder. How I burn the lead is basically the same as how a carbon heater works. The same goes for carbon film resistors. It's made of carbon. So when you apply a lot of electric power, smoke comes out like this, just like the pencil lead. and then eventually burns out. It burned. There are resistors that can handle high power. Such resistors are made of materials that do not burn. They are made of inorganic materials. For example, wire-wound resistors and metal oxide film resistors. The big ones are metal oxide film resistors. The structure is basically the same as this carbon film resistor, but the resistor part is made of metal-based inorganic material. So it doesn't burn. As you can see, they're very different in size. Actually, this is because of the difference in the upper limit of power that can be consumed by the resistors. Usually, larger resistors can consume more power. Another type of resistors that can consume a lot of power is wire-wound resistor, as the name suggests. A wire-wound resistor is a resistor with resistance wire-wound around it. When you apply current, it generates heat. This is a carbon film resistor being applied with high power. The carbon part is burning, then burns out. This is a metal oxide film resistor. When it consumes a lot of power, it turns red like this. It's alarmingly red, but since it's made of metal, it usually doesn't burn. It withstands quite high temperatures, but normally such a high power isn't applied. This is a wire-wound resistor. The wire generates heat, but usually it doesn't get this hot. I'm deliberately applying a large amount of power. These two types are suitable as a load for a large power. Now I'm going to show you resistors with different appearances. These are cement resistors. They are covered by ceramic shells. The inside is filled with cement, which covers the resistance part that generates heat. It's basically made of ceramic, so it's not so expensive. Next, metal-clad resistor. There's also a resistor inside, and it's covered with metal. This one's covered with aluminum, which conducts heat well. Because of that, this resistor dissipates heat very well. But you need to attach it to a heat sink if you want to use it with a rated power. There's another one, vitreous enameled resistor. It's a type of wire-wound resistor. The resistor element is made of ceramic. It's wound by resistance wire and then coated with heat-resistant coating and glaze, which is basically glass. Then it's fired and fused. It's basically made of ceramic and enamel, so it withstands quite a high temperature, up to 200 to 300 degrees Celsius. I'm not sure if there's a situation where it gets so hot, but it withstands really high temperature. Now we have seen two roles of resistors. The first role is to limit the current, and the second role is to act as loads. And there's a third role. The third role is to divide voltage. I'll omit detailed calculation, but when you connect two or more resistors in series, and when the resistors have different resistance values, the voltage applied on each resistor differs. Variable resistor utilizes this nature. This is a variable resistor. There's a knob attached, and you can rotate it. Let's measure the resistance value at the left and middle terminals. When you rotate the knob, the value changes. Most of the resistors I've introduced in this video have metal leads, which are supposed to be soldered on the circuit board. However, these kinds of resistors are not used as much nowadays. They are being replaced by chip resistors. This is a chip resistor. I took it out of the package. It's really small. Conventional resistors are being replaced by these small ones, except for the ones that consume a large amount of power. They are becoming smaller to be used for multifunctional electrical appliances. Here, I have even smaller resistors. Can you see these tiny bits? They are not dust, they are resistors. They are used for very small appliances and high-density appliances. For example, smartphones, wireless earphones, etc. So today I have explained briefly about resistors. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.